It echoed through the whole neighborhood, like bang, 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 bang.
During a deadly confrontation, police shot and killed a man they say was armed with a screwdriver and threatening the lone officer.
Based on not only what the suspect was saying, the threats that were being made, but his aggressive stance, his clearly communicated intention to attack the officer did what was appropriate.
The incident began with police covertly following a couple in a stolen truck and ultimately disabling it. At that point, rather than giving up to police, they got in another stolen truck with an apparent cohort. A short time later, two individuals bailed, one man was shot, and a woman arrested nearby.
I saw flashing of police light, and I know police is around due to the gunshot.
I was just afraid for the family, so I just made sure both the doors were locked.
And I was shaking because it was something too close with my kids around and stuff.
The third man sped from the scene and was arrested in another part of the city, but only after a struggle with the police dog and officers. Hansen, backed by the police association, stands by the actions of the officer.
I can't think of anybody in this city who would say, well, the police officer should have turned on his tail and ran like a scared rabbit. The reality is, these are dangerous people who commit mayhem and havoc in this city, and their intention is to do harm.
When the officer meets with this individual, he's alone, he's in a dark area, he's isolated, doesn't know where the second offender is, and then immediately he is attacked by an offender armed with a weapon who's making threats to use the weapon. In this type of situation, the officer has absolutely no alternative but to engage this individual.
An independent body, Alberta's Serious Incident Response Team, will review the file to determine if the officer's actions were justified and to ensure there was no criminality. Reporting for Sun News, this is Nadia Moharib.